Okay, this truly is an amazing stat. Lightning flashes worldwide over 3 million times a day. That means nobody's house is safe. Now, in fact, insurance companies in the U.S. shell out almost $1 billion for lightning damage every year. Now, this next story, I think, qualifies. Thomas Schaefer got more than he expected during a nasty North Carolina thunderstorm.
We heard your boom, pop, 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 and my hand was on the door and I got a shock.
Lightning struck his fuse box and melted his wires. And that bolt ran through every room.
It split the drywall, burnt the curtain rod. It actually exploded a big antique mirror to a million pieces.
There was never a fire, but an electrician had to rewire his entire house. Insurance covered most of the $10,000 in damages, and Thomas feels lucky to be alive.
It definitely gives you a new perspective of what electricity can do.
Wow, now we want to create that same kind of damage on our disaster house, but making our own lightning, a lot easier said than done. What am I, Zeus? Before we try to create lightning, we need to understand it. For that, we bring in our resident weather nerd, Dr. Christopher Williams. We're talking about lightning, and I know nothing about it. And you know everything about it.
Well, if you know about static electricity when you rub your feet on the carpet, you know about lightning.
Oh, well, I'm smarter than I thought. Let's say the middle of this plasma ball is the ground, which is giving off positive charges called streamers that you can't see. When a cloud up above builds up a negative charge, that's when the fun starts.
When the charge gets large enough, then the bottom of the cloud will start a what's called a step leader, and it goes out in steps in about 50-meter sections approaching the ground. Then there's a return stroke. That is the lightning that we see going from ground back up to the cloud.
No way. So it's the backward motion.
It's the backward motion.
The disaster house is located on the Front Range of Colorado, one of the top areas in the country for lightning strikes. But even then, we can't exactly order up a strike. So we've got to bring the lightning to us. Well, it turns out there is one way to create your own lightning. Courtesy of Dr. Megavolt. By day, Austin Richards is a physicist who works on high voltage systems. By night, he's Dr. Megavolt. And his Tesla coil is his sidekick.
Light him up.
The Tesla coil is like an electrical transformer that starts with 240 volts and it steps it up in stages to 200,000 volts.
That was the coolest thing I've ever seen. How were you able to do that with this getup on?
Well, the Tesla coil puts out very high frequency electricity, and that electricity runs on the surface of conductors. So this metal suit is conductive, so the electricity runs on the outside of it and doesn't get into my body.
And where does it go?
It goes down through the suit into the ground. And if I jump up in the air, it still seeks to pass the ground, so it jumps out of my toes and goes down to the ground.
So it's arcing, basically, down to the ground.
That's right.
So, I got a proposition for you, Dr. Megavolt. You ever use one of those things on a house?
Only my ex-girlfriend's house.
What do you think's gonna happen?
I think it's gonna burn the house.
We're gonna run this Tesla coil at full power right here to simulate a series of lightning strikes on the disaster house. Now, we're hoping it doesn't hit us in the process.
People have died from Tesla coils. The most dangerous part of the machine is that power supply right there. You take your arm right off.
We're about to unleash 200,000 volts on our disaster house. How much is that? Well, imagine all the power that goes into your entire house times that by 1,000. Dr. Megavolt, flip the switch! When we come back, oh, crap! Our lightning sparks some damage. Whoa! We'll tell you how to make repairs after lightning blows out your electrical panel.
There's not a breaker for that.
No.
And tell you how much your insurance will cover.
Will you cover all of that?
Probably not.
They said it couldn't be done. But thanks to Dr. Megavolt and his Tesla coil, we're actually creating lightning. Lightning causes $5 billion in damage each year. We're gonna zap the disaster house to show you what to do if it happens to your house. We're about to unleash 200,000 volts on our disaster house. Dr. Megavolt, flip the switch!
Okay, firing.
Oh, crap! Oh! This is a serious power surge. To put it in perspective, your computer runs off about 5 amps. The Tesla coil is gearing up to blast 6,000 amps. How am I safe right now? Whoa! Yeah! What do you think?
This is awesome. This is 200,000 volts.
Yeah.
Real lightning would have 200 million volts.
So we're on a much smaller scale. The Tesla coil is shooting arcs of electricity at least 15 feet long. Real lightning can shoot bolts up to 10 miles. Almost, we got fire. Now it's going over. Get the tree. Oh, how is that?
When lightning hits the tree, it actually heats all the water that makes it into steam, and the expansion of that steam would blow the tree apart.
When real lightning hits a house, the damage is unpredictable. Sometimes it does nothing. Other times it causes fires. And sometimes it blows out entire electrical systems.
Smoke up there.
Whoa! Woo! Holy! Okay, come on. Watch the wires. Light, toast. Let's see, we got no power on in the house. So that's gone. This thing got crushed. Panel. Totally fried. Nice char. Right there. I can't believe there wasn't a fire. Let's go check out the tree right over here. Something went big. Something went boom. Oh, there it is right there. Wow. It just popped that branch right off. First, let's talk prevention. Lightning rods alone won't protect your house. They need to be installed as part of a full lightning protection system that includes a series of copper wires.
Braided for a reason. Lightning travels on the exterior of the wiring. So that's why you have so many strands, the different strands, so it gives that lightning a better path to ground.
Lightning protection systems are a lot like Dr. Megavolt's suit. If a strike hits it, the electrical current is channeled along the wires and down into the rods buried 10 feet underground. And contrary to popular belief, the rods don't attract lightning.
It just sits on top of your house. So if lightning is going to hit it, it gives